BBC Hereford and Worcester.
In session tonight.
Time for our first bit of live music then. They're from Hereford. It's Talons.
Introducing.
So just an incredible wall of sound there. You've been Oofats before, you've been Kites before, and now you've kind of metamorphosized into this new sound, haven't you?
Yeah.
Well, how's it all kind of changed over the years? Does it sound different to what it did, you know, 3-4 years ago?
Yeah, I think it's changed a lot, really, because kind of different members have come and gone, and I guess we've sort of matured a bit in the stuff we listen to, and I think we just try to, because Oofats, I guess, it's a long time ago, and it's just a bit of fun, really, and I think now it's kind of just a bit more serious and sort of a bit more... you know, we still have fun, but it's the sound, I think, has just evolved. We're just sort of a bit more growing up in that sound as well, so, yeah.
I noticed that on drums, you're very, very prepared. You've got a couple of drumsticks there. So if, like, during the course of that record, you're playing and the drumstick shoots off, you've got a couple of drumsticks on the go, like that. Which is more than what happens with your fiddle player. That's rare, though. Two people playing... What is it? Fiddle or violin? I can never tell the difference.
Violin, they're the same thing.
Is it? It's just how you play it.
Fiddle's more known as
like a
yeah, that's it. You've got to have a finger in the ear.
Kind of Irish, folky sort.
Okay, because that's quite unusual to be able to have two violins in a rock band.
Yeah, it's very true.
I think it's quite unique. So.
What's also unique is it's an instrumental band. What happened to your singer?
Well, that's a long time ago now, but he joined the Navy for some reason.
Okay.
When I bought a Land Rover.
Yeah, bought a Land Rover, joined the Navy. I think he's probably somewhere off the coast of France at the moment.
Okay.
Looking after fishermen, I think. But.
So you've travelled all over the country recently, haven't you?
Yeah, we've been doing quite a few gigs and stuff. We played in, where was it?
London
last weekend. Got a few, like, it's been a bit quiet because the guys have had exams and stuff. So, yeah, we're kind of just trying to get out there as many people as possible, really, so, yeah.
And Flo works on this programme, I think, saw you in Nottingham.
Yeah, she
says that was absolutely fantastic gig and was raving about you as well. So, how long exactly has it been since you guys got together then?
In this lineup, I guess,
November?
No, August.
Oh. No,
well, sorry, first gig we played with this lineup was 21st of August. So almost, but getting on to a year. But we kind of, even in that time, we've changed a lot as a band. So
yeah, we have a whole new set of songs.
Yeah, so it's because when we changed from Kites to Talons, we're kind of doing Kite stuff with a couple of new members and stuff, but now we've kind of, you know, it's all completely new, so.
And when was Oofats? How long ago were we talking about then? When
years.
It kind of...
trying to think, maybe 2006, 2007?
Oli's the only original.
Yeah, I'm the only one who's actually in that now, so, you know, quite a lot of change.
It's almost a new band.
I think it is a new band, yeah.
Okay. Where's been your best gig so far?
Clubby for back in
Cardiff, yeah.
In Cardiff was pretty, yeah.
Possibly Worcester, yeah.
Yeah, it's really fun.
Worcester, we managed to sell a lot of merchandise and people really liked it.
It's really nice. It's just in the Firefly, which you probably know is quite small. And it's just odd because, you know, you sometimes go to the like bigger cities and expect them to be the best shows, but it was kind of the Worcester one, which was just really good fun. Everyone just really liked it, so it kind of makes, you know, it's nice when that happens, really, so.
I think you're just about ready to do another track. He looks like he's just about to tune. Do you want another couple of minutes?
I did snap a string on that song. So I
was very
noticed.
Impressed. I didn't notice. So, lost a drumstick and lost the string in the course of the song and still managed to keep a tight thing. That's practice for you. How often do you practice it?
Once a week, maybe? At least once a week, really, yeah.
And where do you get to do that? Do you get complaining neighbours?
It's all at my house, and luckily for us, they're really nice people, so they're kind of... So they, as long as we kind of tell them beforehand, they don't really mind. Yeah. So they're really good about it. Yeah.
Excellent stuff. So a bit more live music here on the Friday session. Introducing, they're from Hereford. It's Talons. live music from Talons here on Friday Session, introducing on BBC Hereford and Worcester.
Pop, trance, rock, dance, punk, drum and bass, R&B, soul, house, acoustic, hip-hop, folk, thrash metal, indie, chill out, reggae, rap. Mashing up the styles. You'll hear it first on the Friday Session.
Introducing. Time for a bit more live music then. They're from Hereford. It's Talons. Live music from Talons. Friday Session. Introducing. Talons. What's that mean then? Where do you get a name like that?
Well, our friend Will Berry actually came up with it, I think.
Yeah.
And it was just, I don't know, just a random name that we liked.
Well, it's quite epic, something we wanted to get, something that represents
epic
our sound,
vibe.
Really. Yeah, the epic vibe.
And it's kind of a direct, kind of carries on from kites as a bird sort of thing, so we want to keep that kind of...
What are talons? Are they birds, are they?
Well, they're like the claws
of a bird.
The claws of like of an eagle or a bird of prey, really, so kind of... I don't know.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
You've also been supported as well, Radio 1, Huw Stephens, on his introducing show not too long ago as well. That must have been quite a special moment for you.
Yeah, it's quite fun. Yeah. It's kind of just out of the blue, really, and it's quite...
Got a text from Mr. Scavon when I was in my history lesson.
Yeah, it's Jay Scavon there, our manager. Can't make it today. Katie's got the car, so... he'll probably be at home listening to it now, chuckling to himself. So this one's for you, Uncle Carbonara.
Yeah, what is that carbonara thing which I've seen on Facebook recently?
Oh, it's very popular. Joe is, well, his second name is Scavon. Some people assume he's Italian mafia, and that's where the joke comes from.
So right. It's like expanded to Chicago town as well.
Deep banding.
Brilliant.
Brilliant. Childish, to be honest.
Well, it's got to be like that. Anything ever gone wrong on stage for you lot?
Pickup just fell off. We're not really on
stage. Yeah, well, we're just classic like string breaks.
Break
yeah, he's broken a bass.
We've been pretty lucky though. Oh. We don't really have many times when it's a struggle. But okay, it's alright.
Pretty unique sound you guys have got. So who are you listening to? What are you citing as influences?
Well. I tend to listen to probably more of the instrumentals, other bands' instrumental, sort of Pelican,
Circles.
Russian Circles are there, but
I'm kind of into Botch at the moment.
Yeah,
quite heavy, quite nice.
Yeah, I think there's the subtle sort of undertones of hip hop, crunk, and also a bit of electronica, but very quietly in the mix there.
So you guys have also been in other kind of outfits as well, haven't you? Other bands?
Yeah. Olympic Arms is one that's obviously a Hereford favourite.
Me and Rue are also in Gossamer Albatross. And then
yeah, we did a session it was a three-piece
a year and a half ago.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah.
And apart from that, you know, what's the next step for you guys? What do you hope to achieve out of this this newly renamed band?
We're all going to be in Hereford sort of next year, so we're just going to try and blitz it really and just do as
hopefully
many shows.
Album
sort of next year as well. Just go for it really and keep on having. You know, main thing is just have fun, play as many shows as we can.
Tell me about this label.
Big Sky Monsters, they're based in Oxford.
Oh right, yeah, they're the ones who kind of originally signed Sam Isaac, wasn't it? From from Get Kate, Wear Kate, Fly. So how did that kind of come back?
Sent him a few tracks over
and
he really liked it.
Yeah, Joe got in touch and
and then he saw us live and then
I think
that sealed it.
Love really.
Good stuff. Well, you're going to do another track for us now, the last one, and what's this one about and what inspired you to write this?
This is a new
based
one.
Around riffage.
Yeah, it's called Bethlehem. It sort of represents...
Working title.
A working title, but it sounds a bit like Bethlehem and maybe something Jesus would have listened to himself on the banks of Galilee.
Definitely.
Wow.
Not sure about that.
They didn't have distorted guitars back then.
I think, yeah, it's like historical inaccuracy.
Live music there. From Talons. Thank you. From Hereford. That's the awesome live sounds of Talons.
In session.
BBC Hereford and Worcester.
An interesting question from Ken Wintonian. Do manatees go on their band rider?
BBC Introducing with Andrew Marston.